Bachelor Nation is also facing some big controversy over one of its contestants. Rachel Kirkconnell, who is competing for Matt James's heart in this season of The Bachelor, is apologizing after photos of her at a plantation-themed party resurfaced. The photos that were posted on Reddit show Rachel with her sorority sister enjoying an Old South bash on a plantation in 2018. Rachel says she didn't recognize how offensive and racist her actions were at the time. She says she was ignorant, but her ignorance was racist. Meantime, Bachelor host Chris Harrison is also in hot water after he defended those pictures while speaking to former Bachelorette Rachel Lindsey on Extra. He said the pictures were not a good look, but said they shouldn't be judged by today's standards because they were from 2018. So yesterday, 25 women from this season said they were disappointed with Chris's statements and said they denounced any defense of racism.
Ooh, because there's two things on this one. The Rachel Kirkconnell girl, I don't think she should be canceled at all. Because like she said, that racism could have been a form of ignorance. It's a teaching moment. Like, you know, Jeff, I'm not trying to cancel everyone out there.
Absolutely.
Do I think that canceling everyone is going to end racism? Absolutely not. I am not that naive to it. I think that when we get to these moments, but the problem I do have is with Chris Harrison, because the way he was trying to double down, and yes, he was trying to defend some sort of actions back in 2018, saying like, oh, well, that's, you know, 2018. We looked at it through that lens. You know what that sounded like to me? Megyn Kelly, when the whole blackface thing, where she was like, oh, well, back in the day, we all wore blackface. It was the cool thing to do. To your community, it was not offensive to your community. So I look at this and I'm like, we have to use this as a teaching moment, because if you think of The Bachelor, and what they're trying to being forced to do now, modernizing love, right? Because we have so many biracial families running through the United States. My brother and my sister-in-law and my biracial nieces and nephews, they have to be at the front of this. Chris Harrison, you've stepped in it with this one.
Yeah.
He has to, if you're going to continue to be the host, you have to show that not only you and your opinion and your voice is inclusive, but the show has to push him to do that as well, because this is a hot show. Everyone watches the show. People, I mean, it gets great ratings, but pushing forward where we're going in America, where we're going with love, we can't have it, but we also just can't cancel everybody for
right.
things in the past. Otherwise, I wouldn't be up here for
right.
some of this
stuff.
Right,
and I'm with you, but here's where I kind of get worried. I'm not defending Chris Harrison. Is there room to maybe question something? Like, hey, I didn't know I was at a plantation and I just took this picture. Or she didn't know. And then immediately you're going to get canceled because you just asked an innocent question that something you were maybe ignorant about in the first place, right? That's where my skepticism comes in, because the whole Black Lives Matter thing, I'm down for it.
Yeah.
And it needs to happen, and I appreciate you mentioning biracial couples. But when it comes to that and I have a question and I'm like scared to ask it, and people are like, well, you better educate yourself because you're part of the problem, it makes me more silent.
Yes.
Because I'm scared
yep.
to ask yep. even a question, because I know it's ignorant, but I'm just trying to educate myself by asking, but apparently that's not the right way. So do you understand like how I could step in it? Like I am kind of now.
You're really not though. Who are you stepping into? It's the loudest tweet that we read that
exactly.
makes a tweet. But in terms of progression, we have to cross over those lines. You have to ask these questions. And even if we sit down, we're having a beer, I'm like, whoa, Jeff, it's 2021. We said this back in 2018, and why are you still asking the question?
Right.
We still have to ask that, because maybe I didn't explain that right, or maybe you're not seeing things because you grew up in a completely different environment than I grew up. Same with you, Stephanie.
Mm-hmm.
I just, it's one of those things where I'm like, maybe being from both sides of the railroad tracks and being the only Black kid on baseball teams and neighborhoods, I've seen some things, but at the same time, it's like, to progress, we have to be able to have uncomfortable conversations.
Exactly.
And
maybe
to cancel people.
Maybe I'm more comfortable with it growing up in sports, and like we go out after work, or We used to. Good old days.
We used to.
And I could ask those questions, right, and feel comfortable about that, and we just talk about it, and there was no repercussions from that. But if you do that in a public setting, do you feel this at all, Steph? Do you get
what we're saying? Absolutely. I think in particular when I moved from London originally to America, I used to have extensive conversations with Erica about it, our co-host I mentioned earlier. I think at times she never made me, I was very lucky in the fact that she never criticized me or made me feel uncomfortable. She just spoke to me about it, and I was very ignorant and unaware, and I didn't really know, and I was just trying to wrap my head around it. But I think that's the most important thing. If your intentions are good and you're genuinely trying to understand, it might be sometimes be uncomfortable, but that's the only way, as Brandon says, that anyone is ever going to move forward, you know?
Yep. Yeah.
So I'm with you. I think, you know, we've all got so much to learn. We don't know everything.
Well, I do.
Yeah.
Absolutely not.